justice yet in the senseless crime that ended the life of a prominent St. Louis County government employee near a Metro bus stop on Grand Avenue last week. The shooting also injured the man who police say was arguing with the gunman. Police didn't have an update on his condition today, but could only say he is stable. St. Louis City Police, though not releasing many other details, are still trying to figure out who did the shooting and if more than one person was involved.
Number 70, Grand 2, Broadway Metro Bus Center.
The unsolved case is a bit unnerving for Chris Leip, who frequents the area where the deadly shooting happened.
It's scary and it's, you know, frustrating that, you know, it's taken taking time to find out who did this, and I hope that they can find them soon.
Leip, however, says since the shooting, he's noticed increased security on some Metrolink trains and platforms.
Officers with, you know, badges and vests and all the equipment on the train I just got off of, so they're definitely trying to make it, you know, look as safe as possible.
Meanwhile, Metro officials are urging the public to come forward with answers.
This is very serious. Having people, you know, in broad daylight on a street in the city of St. Louis trying to go home subject to this type of violence is an extremely serious thing, and it needs to be corrected, it needs to be addressed, and everybody needs to work together.
For the community, that means staying alert, being aware of their surroundings, and reporting anything suspicious while police continue their search for the killer.
I just have fear, you know, when I step out, not at night. I don't be out at night, but up during the day, I have fear because, you know, bullets don't have any eyes, and you never know what's going to hit you. You never know.